We are going to be familiarized with function generator. So what is a generator actually? The generator is a device which produces an electrical signal as our output. The function generator is a device which produces different types of electrical signals or different functions of electrical signals like sine, square, pulse and etc. Now in this is a function generator which produces a maximum frequency of 3 megahertz mentioned over here. So here the function generator will be consisting of different controls and different switches. So there are of 5 switches and 4 control knobs. So here the first one is frequency switch. So this frequency switch or range switch. So here we will be able to select the range of our frequency. By defaultly it will give 3 kilohertz. Suppose if I press this button, it will be changing to 30 kilohertz. And if you press this one, it is changing in terms of 10 times. So the minimum frequency range is 3 and the maximum frequency range is 0.33 mega. So at this place we will be able to measure 3 megahertz. So if you want to measure a frequency of 1 hertz, so we have to select in such a way that range must be equal to maximum value is 3. So this is the maximum value. And we are having another switch called function. This function is used to change the function of an electrical signal, such as by default it is sine. If you press function, it goes to triangle, pulse, TTL, sine and square. Okay, so totally of 6 waveforms it will be generating, and this is the modulation output. So that means if you press this button, it gives the modulation output of AMS, amplitude modulation, FM, frequency modulation, pulse width modulation and off. Off means it doesn't produce any modulation. And there is a attenuation button. Attenuation button will be in terms of dB. So by default it will be dB, 0 dB. And if you press this button, it goes to 20 dB and it goes to 40 dB. So at 0 dB position, we will be getting a maximum amplitude of 20 volts peak to peak. So here it is mentioned that 20 volts peak to peak. So this attenuation button is a range selector in terms of voltage. And whereas this frequency is a range selector in terms of frequency. So if you press this button, we will be able to change the range of function generator in terms of frequency. So first it is mentioning 3. So at this range, so we will be getting a minimum frequency of 0.1 hertz to 3 hertz. Suppose if you press here 3, 30. So at 30 position, we will be able to get a frequency of 3 hertz to 30 hertz. So if you press again 300. So here 30 hertz to a maximum frequency of 300 hertz. And if you press it, it goes to 3k. So at 3k position, 300 hertz to 3k. And at 30k, we will be getting from 3k to 30 kilohertz. So here it is 0.3 megahertz, or else it can be 300 kilo. So at this position, 30 kilohertz to 0.3 megahertz. So here we will be getting a maximum of 3 mega, that is 0.3 megahertz to 3 megahertz. So in this way, In this way, we have to select our range such that our frequency has to be there. Okay, suppose if our frequency is 1 kilohertz, so we have to select which range our frequency is. Suppose if it is 1 kilo, our range is 3k. So that means our 1 kilo range comes in that 3k. So we have to select 3k mode for selecting frequencies from 300 hertz to 3 kilohertz. So, and but depending upon our frequency, this range has to be selected. Okay. So here 1 kilohertz frequency I have set. So this setting has to be done by changing this frequency variable knob. So this is a variable knob, so which will rotate in clockwise and anticlockwise direction, and which changes the values of this value, frequency value. And we have selected a frequency range. So particular frequency, if you want to change, this frequency variable will be varied, and display it shows here as frequency of 0.61 hertz presently. Suppose if I want to set it to 1 kilohertz, so I am slowly anti-clockwise direction in order to lower the value of our frequency. Now I set to a 1.01 kilohertz frequency. Now second, this button is function button. So function button is used to change the electrical functions of a signal, that is sine to square, triangle, pulse, amplitude. So there are number of only six functions can be able to generate by using this function generator. This modulation is used in communication labs. So as of now we don't need. So this modulation will be helpful in higher classes. So this is the attenuation button, which is a range selector in terms of voltage. Suppose attenuation, if the attenuation is selected to 0 dB, it gives a maximum voltage of 20 volts. So what is the minimum voltage? So the minimum voltage is 2 volts peak to peak. At 0 dB, it is from 2 volts to 20 volts peak to peak. At 20 dB, it will be from 0.2 volts peak to peak to 2 volts peak to peak. And at 40 dB, it will give a minimum voltage of 0.02 volts peak to peak to 0.2 volts peak to peak value. Control knobs, one is duty cycle, second one is frequency variable, third one is amplitude variable, fourth one is DC offset. So this duty cycle is used for pulse waveform function. So whereas it is used to change the time period of off time to on time, that means it is used to vary the pulse duration. And this frequency variable knob is used to vary the frequency so that the value is set to our desired value. And this is an amplitude variable, so it varies amplitude from 0 to a maximum value of 20 volts peak to peak depending upon your attenuation value. And this is a DC offset, which cancels the DC levels in our signal. And this is the place where we collect the output, and this is not the place we collect the output. This is the place we collect the output, and this is the input given to this function generator in order to modulate the signal. So this is an instrument or device called as oscilloscope. So what is a scope? The place where we see something is said to be a scope. Oscilloscope means the place where we see the oscillations of a signal is called a oscilloscope. So this type of oscilloscope is a analog type. So where we need to calculate manually. So here there are many different buttons and knobs in order to control the waveform. and it is a two channel oscilloscope where we can give two signals at a time and we can collect both the signals output at a time. And here we are having different knobs. So this is the power knob. So if you press power, it will be oning, and this is 10x. So it is going to multiply your signal in 10 times. Okay, whereas XY is used to find the Lissajous figures and CRO, and whereas channel 1 and channel 2 is used to select. Suppose if it is pressed, it will be selecting channel 2. If it is not selected or not pressed, it will be selecting channel 1. So here mono or duo, suppose if you press these two, so there will be two outputs at a time. So we can measure both the outputs in dual mode. And if it is not pressed, it is a mono mode, depending upon this button, whether either channel 1 or channel 2 selected output will be visible here. So here there is a alt or chop. Alt or chop will be given in order to invert your waveform. And this one EXT is a external trigger given to a CRO. And this is X-shift. X-shift moves the waveform in horizontal plane. And whereas Y-shift moves in vertical plane. So this is the multiplication factor of our signal. So based on this, we need to multiply in order to calculate a frequency and amplitude. So this is the volts per division knob, so which is used to change the waveform in Y direction, and this is the time per division which is used to change in X direction. So if you change this one, it is changing the TB, time per division, and if it is change one, it is changing voltage per in channel 1. Suppose if you want to select channel 2, press this button, it will goes to channel 2. The star indicates that selected channel, and channel 2 and this is the channel 1 and this is the channel 2. So channel 2 and channel 1 will be having three separate switches, where first one is ground. So if you press on the ground, though we give the signal, it shows only a blank line, straight line like this waveform. And if you release, whatever the signal we give, it will be displaying. This AC or DC button is used to select the modes in either waveform is in AC or DC mode. For the same way, this channel 2 knobs are also there. So suppose let us connect the signal in order to check the output of a signal. So here I have connected 3 kilo. I have selected 3 kilo range. And I am giving a frequency of 2.2 kHz from function generator. I need to connect the output across here. And I am giving this one to my function generator channel 1 as my output. Now here it is not displaying any value. So in order to display something, so we need to change the both these two knobs such a way that we can see a waveform of sinusoidal wave. Here it is sinusoidal wave, so we have to get the sinusoidal wave here. So before seeing that, we need to press ground such that this line position has to be at the center of this one. So in order to set it center, we need to make Y position to ground and release. After that, release the ground button. Now select it to channel 1, change this value of channel 1 volts per division such that you see some waveform, and change the time period value. So you will be getting a sinusoidal wave whose frequency has to be in matched with this 2.2 kilohertz. So now let us check whether these two frequencies are matched or not. So we need to calculate the frequency. What is frequency? Frequency equal to number of oscillations per second. Number of oscillations per second. What is time period? 1 by frequency is the time period. Here by this we will be calculating time period. So inverse of time period will be frequency. So now let us calculate the time period. So time period means the time taken to complete one oscillation. So here by changing this x direction and by keeping this as my reference, the wave is taking some values. So how to calculate that values is, so here the wave is taking some boxes 1, 2, 3, 4 and 4.6. So it is taking a value of 4.6. So if you want to calculate time period, so here this is a place where we see the our oscillations. So here we are having 10 divisions on vertical horizontal axis and 8 divisions on vertical axis. So each division has again subdivided into 5 equal parts. That means each part is of 0.2. So here if you calculate the signal now, so that the waveform is taking 1, 2, 3, 4, 4.6 boxes. 4.6 boxes. So time period equal to 4.6 into the given time period here. So the given time period is 0.1 millisecond. So we will be getting 0.46 milliseconds as our time period. So what is frequency? Frequency equal to 1 by time period, that is 1 by 0.46 millisecond, that is 1000 by 0.46. So it will be around or approximately equal to our given frequency, that is 2.21 kilohertz. Now if we want to calculate the amplitude, so what we know amplitude is, amplitude will be in y direction. So amplitude, in order to calculate amplitude, we need to calculate the y position boxes. That means number of divisions it is taking on y axis or vertical axis. So by changing this one in such a way that I kept a reference line as this one. So from that it is taking how many divisions? So it is taking 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now it is taking amplitude equal to number of divisions. Amplitude equal to number of divisions on y-axis into volts per division. So here it is taking 7 divisions on y-axis and the volts per division value is, channel 1 is 1. 7 into 1, that is 7 volts. So 7 volts is the peak to peak value of our amplitude, and this 7 volts peak to peak we will be getting in only 0 dB. So see here, it will be 0 dB. Suppose if I press 20 dB, so we won't get more than 2 volts at this 20 dB. So if you calculate it, you will be getting 0.7 volts peak to peak at 20 dB for same amplitude value without changing the amplitude variable. Just we are changing only attenuation. Suppose if you change to 40 dB, this value will be equal to 0.07 volts peak to peak. So that is equal to 70 millivolts peak to peak. So once you see, So here it is taking number of divisions on y axis 1.4. It is taking 1.4. So 1.4 into 50 millivolts. So that is equal to 70 millivolts peak to peak. So peak to peak means, so from here at this position it is said to be ground. From ground to a maximum or in positive direction is said to be V peak. From ground to negative direction is said to be minus V peak. So the total V amplitude is treated as V peak to peak. From negative peak to from positive peak is treated as V peak to peak value. Now let us check the different functions. So now basically first by default it will be sine wave. If we change to square, so this is a square waveform. Okay, and if you press again it is triangle, so the output will be triangle. And next it is pulse. So this is pulse. So we have already discussed about the duty cycle. This duty cycle is used in pulse. So in order to change this value, so here 0 is maximum and 1 is minimum. So in order to change that, from that this is used. Duty cycle is used to change the 0 levels width. Okay. Next is ramp. So it seems to be like a triangular but more slope. Next is pulse TTL. So TTL you will be getting this type of a square waveform with voltage of 5 volts peak to peak. So there is an important note that at TTL position, so you won't change any dB value. So we cannot change the attenuation value. So the dB is fixed and we'll be getting only 5 volts as our output. So TTL means transistor logic.